Welcome back to, what is this, volume one, chapter six?
Yes.
Of Nerd Turd Talks.
That is
correct. The Mandalorian, aka the Space Pirate.
Where we are covering this Mandy the Space Pirate's adventures through space with our with his dear friend, Baby Yoda. Mm-hmm. And episode six, honestly, is a pretty straightforward episode. So it kind of is, he needs some money. He goes up into one of his old contacts and then basically gets a band of merry men led by what do they call it? A
nice Christmas joke there, by the way. Merry men.
Yeah. Ooh, that was for you guys.
There's a woman as well, though.
Also, Merry Christmas, everybody. But almost. What did he? He wasn't a stormtrooper. What was he? A sharpshooter for something for the Empire? An Imperial sharpshooter? Is that what they called him?
Something like that. I can't remember exactly the language of it.
Because Mandy specifically made a joke of like, well, that doesn't help because it's like, you know, count. Just a Star Wars meme that no.
That's like the people who are like Marines that like make fun of people in the Air Force and they're like, well, that doesn't count.
We respect all service members here at the Nerd Turd. At the Nerd Turd podcast.
Yes.
But then so they go from there. They go into, I guess they're like trying to, you know, rescue some one of their friends who doesn't seem like he's really a friend to anybody. He seems like
he's
more
super
everyone.
Super mean. It's just like the girl's brother, the Twi'lek's brother, which is like weird to me.
Yeah. So I wasn't like
Why
entirely
risk all that
sure.
To do that?
Well, yeah, I wasn't entirely sure what the relationship there or the benefit of freeing him, but that's what they're going for, and it kind of feeds back into Mandy's mysterious hatred of droids, which I'm willing to and able to learn more about, but I'm not given the opportunity yet. Because this is a droid run like prison facility, essentially,
which is a pretty cool facility.
Yeah, it was actually pretty dope.
The facility was cool.
Also, you know, I know y'all's qualms with Mandy at this point has been that they call him an elite bounty hunter, but then he keeps getting beat up. I feel like
put that to rest this episode, I believe.
I feel like this episode
where I thought it was like he was good. He did his thing.
He definitely should have scratched the itch of all right, yeah. So this dude knows what's going on.
Yeah, he did pretty well.
Definitely the most action packed. It was cool. He kind of just did his thing the whole time.
That's and also so, the kind. I'm glad we finally got to see an episode of him just like straight up like flexing on people. You know,
yeah,
like not.
We needed that.
Well, so and honestly, it took me a while just to figure out like this is the rhythm of this show. Like
yeah,
the first six episodes. Like this isn't about story development. Basically, each episode is its own independent thing of like the adventures of the Mandalorian. Essentially,
yeah, it's almost like a sitcom. Like and Friends. So, like it's just like an episode where they just do something.
Well, and I think for a while, and us too, we were actually incorrect about this. And I don't know if this was like we were lied to, or maybe we just bought into the hype of everyone else. But I guess I assumed that somehow all of this stuff that was going to go on was tying into the Rise of Skywalker.
Yeah,
and so I think everyone was kind of like, all right, there's a baby Yoda now. How does this tie into everything? Yeah. And they might literally just be making a show where they don't explain that.
Which I think might be, I think that is one of the things, like with Star Wars in general, and if you listen to our latest episode, the reason people get so mad is if you tie into something else, it affects other things, right? You can't just go change the past. And so like maybe just having a Star Wars adventure that's just a good story that's fun is what they need to do, right? Like maybe they don't need to try to connect everything. Maybe we just need a Mandalorian story about a guy who finds a baby and
who's force sensitive.
Yeah, I mean, yeah. Cool.
Interesting.
Yeah,
I think
so I think the world will erupt if they don't explain like what this baby Yoda is. But honestly, I think from like a quality standpoint, I almost think like that might be the move. Because if you the moment you introduce something like it's Yoda's baby or you know something like that, you're gonna have
at this point like,
you're gonna divide everyone.
You?
Everyone's like, "What? Yoda had a baby?"
When
we're
literally
all mad.
He's the most universally loved things in fandom.
Yeah,
right
yeah.
Now.
And so I don't know. Maybe they won't do it, you know. But it kind of seems like at this point. I mean, we're recording it for episode six, but we'll talk about episode seven here in a, you know, on our next episode. Just make sure to you know stay tuned. Let the auto roll go through. But we're seven episodes into this,
and there's only one more in this season.
Mm-hmm. Is that true? There's
only episode eight. There's only eight episodes.
So yeah, I mean, I literally think that they're just like. Like literally, like the crazy times of the Mandalorian and Baby Yoda.
Essentially, yeah, I definitely think that you guys talking about it in that light, like for me, maybe kind of settles a little bit, maybe not, because I still think it is hard to wrap my mind around that we have had, you know, seven episodes, and there hasn't really been a plot.
Yeah, hardly
per
any
se,
story progression.
You know, and I think that I was. Again, maybe as we all were going in with the preconceived notion that it was all going to lead into something that tied into the end of the saga or tied into the canon of Star Wars, which is obviously it's not saying that it still can't, but there hasn't really been a cohesive plot to these seven episodes.
Yeah, yeah. Like, there's not really been like a linear story. And I thought
that was
going to
happen, and so I've been kind of a little frustrated with it. Also frustrated with the fact that they have deemed Mandy throughout the entirety of these seven episodes now as like an elite and the best of the best when it comes to the galaxy's bounty hunters. And up until this point, he has basically gotten himself beaten up in every situation that he's gotten into. So they kind of resolved that for me, and I'll give them that. But I am curious to see where it's going and what's going to happen. Like, is there any going to be any resolution, or is it just going to be basically, is this just almost like an origin instead of like an origin story that you get in, you know, the cinematic universe of Marvel and, you know, Star Wars and other things? Like, instead of it being like an origin story movie, they've just done this now as like an entire series on Disney Plus. So like, this is just the origin of who Mandy is and who the Mandalorian is. And they're going to do something. Obviously, there are more seasons planned. You know, in the future, they're going to do something more plot-based. I don't know. That's, the, I think, the only thing that I would be pining and yearning for, I guess, at this point.
Well, let me... So, and you know, we kind of got derailed, but... So, basically, they're on a mission, free this dude. There's a droid-run prison facility.
So, they thought. Does it end up being completely
droid-run?
There is
a thought. And so, you get a cool scene of Mandy just... You know, just, you know, basically WWE RKO and like
anything
nine,
and everything.
Yeah,
in
nine droids in his path. He's just going crazy right after a moment where they're like, oh, this Mandalorian's not even doing it. Like the big red Incredible Hulk guy who's super inexplicably strong. Inexplicably strong. And then the big thing. You find out there's a person on this. Mm-hmm. It's not just a droid run prison
well,
facility.
Even before that, so that's definitely the big spoiler because that's the reason like he goes and they're like, this should be a fairly easy, you know, mission and easy money in the bag because it's droid run and it's super easy to get around and like work around with the droids. But before that, I think what kind of like takes it to where it goes, and we'll keep talking as we talk about it more, is obviously, Mandy's trying to keep a low profile with these people that he just wants to work with for the money because he didn't want to go with a team, but they needed a team per his friend, you know, to do this mission. And along the way, they discover Baby Yoda. So if you remember that portion, they accidentally like bump into the hatch thing where Baby Yoda's just kind of chilling. And then the droid who is flying the ship starts seeing like broken pieces of the transmission that basically clues them in that
like something's going down.
Mandy has the bounty that everyone in the galaxy is after now, and so that's where it kind of turns to where they like have ulterior motives, or maybe they were planning to do that the whole time, I don't know, you know, but they get clued in to more of who Mandy is as he's trying to keep this low profile in the galaxy and not let them know what he has with him.
Yep.
You know,
and so they roll up on this dude, and then they're basically immediately just going to kill him. And then he pulls out what they call a tracking beacon, mm-hmm. which you don't really find out what it is, but you just know something bad is going to happen if he presses it, right?
Yeah, well, he says if he like hits the distress signal within within minutes, an Empire destroyer will be on their location and it'll basically like open fire and ask questions later, you know?
So anyway, they Mandy wants them to not kill this guy. They accidentally end up doing, or not accidentally.
Yeah, the girl out of nowhere throws a knife. And
yeah,
just like
they're arguing with him, trying to get him not to press the button. Yeah,
knife throws him in the throat.
And yeah, and he accidentally, or you know, on his way down in his fall, presses the button. Mm-hmm. And so now this tracking beacon's active. Fast forward maybe 1 minute, you've got this crew that they're supposed to, like, now it's like, we got to get moving. This place is about to get blown to smithereens. Mm-hmm. And then that's when they betray him and throw him into a prison cell after Mandy picks up the tracking beacon that's now beeping, and he looks at it, and you are kind of clued into the fact like, all right, maybe he's got this situation under control.
Yeah. Well, they come to find out that the person they're coming to rescue, because he doesn't know who they're rescuing. He just knows that they're trying to do like a rescue mission. Comes to find out, I don't remember the name, but it's the, I don't remember any of their names from the episode besides Mandy, obviously, right now, but
the
Twi'lek that is part of the crew that doesn't, brother. that he is associated with immediately when they open the hatch doors of the prison cell, Mandy knows who it is, and it's her brother, who he's also well acquainted with to some extent. And he doesn't like him, and Mandy doesn't like him.
Yeah,
they don't like each other.
There.
You know, immediately once he realizes who that they're rescuing. And shortly after that, you know, as soon as they do that, he comes out, tides turn, Mandy gets thrown in, you know. So left on the left on the prison ship to be what you would think.
Yeah. And this is when you start seeing full on Mandy.
Yeah,
Mandy
just goes wild.
He gets locked up in this thing. First thing he does, he yoinks over a droid, rips that thing's
yoink.
He arm bars that droid's arm right off, gets out of that prison. Then he basically just starts going on a one by one warpath, basically just knocking out all these nerds one by one.
Separates them, locks them into like a closet, not a closet, just like a corridor. He finds a way to just like close the doors, right?
Well, I also really appreciated the fact that they were like insinuating the fact that all these people were dying.
Yeah.
But then, because he's a bounty hunter and he's killed a lot of people at this point in this series,
mm-hmm.
but then he keeps all of them alive, stranded on this ship.
Yeah.
And
well, you end up finding out that he just threw them all in the cell that he was in, I think. Because it like
is
cuts
that where
to,
they
I'm pretty sure that's
cell.
What it was.
Okay.
I think that's what they insinuated, because at the end of it, it like cuts back and they're all kind of waking up and they're still on the like the prison ship, and I think they're all in the cell that he like escaped from.
Yeah. And cool. So
full circle, you know?
Yeah, yeah. And then so, you know, at this point, you know, nothing's blown up yet, so you're assumed to believe that tracking thing, I guess, is now
was a false alarm.
Was under control. But they go back, turn in the job. One of the policies that, you know, you find out whoever this guy is that he gets this job from, it's like a no questions asked kind of thing. And so he asks Mandy, he's like, yo, where's the rest of the crew? He says, no questions asked, right? And he hands
so that's the deal.
Mandy the money. And then as soon as Mandy gets in the ship, takes off, he calls a order to shoot him down, to kill him.
Whole ship explodes.
That's when, boom, joke's on you. Mandy's already tracking Beacon Jew, and now you've got X-Wings flying up your butt.
Yeah, I was going to say, so I mistakenly spoke and said Star Destroyer, but it was definitely like X-Wings.
I was going to make sure to correct you, bro.
Yeah, they came in hot. But yeah.
All in all, though, I think this is a super fun episode. Like,
lots of action.
I think, yeah, because like some of the episodes have been pretty slow because they've been introducing characters for seemingly no reason because, you know, they haven't really played a huge point in the plot yet, other than like for that one specific episode.
Mm-hmm.
But you got to see this bounty hunter who's been called the goat
greatest
bounty
in
hunter
the galaxy,
in
yeah.
the galaxy.
You got to see him be a bounty hunter, which I appreciate.
Yeah, and so you even had people who were like super skeptical of him just because he was a Mandalorian, because apparently just no one knows, like, has actually seen a Mandalorian. Like, they've only heard legends of him.
Yeah.
And you know, so he got to do so well that even those people that were like, this guy, blew him apart.
So yeah.
Did you like it?
I liked it.
Thought it was a great episode, full of action.
Still nothing happened in regards to the whole story, but as far as a separate sitcom-esque episode, it was enjoyable.
Yep. What if they just choke this here in the last 2 minutes and just try to tie it all together? Or two episodes?
What, you're saying The Rise of Skywalker?
Oh,
wow.
If you want to hear our thoughts on The Rise of Skywalker, then you can check out episode 34 of the Nerd Turd podcast. Links in the description, I assume. And, but, no, I'm talking about, what if it, like, the last two episodes here, they basically just, like, completely choke this whole thing, and they give this Baby Yoda like the, you know, the most like botched origin story ever.
Yeah.
Like, how disappointing is that going to be? Because this show has been such a good time.
Would it be surprising?
No.
I'm really interested to see what they do with it.
Me too.
We'll see.
Well, we'll see.
I really am.
Lots of action, not lots of plot.
Yeah. I'll end it here. But I hope they don't do anything with it. I hope it's just a fun time. I hope they just leave it a fun time and don't try to overdo it.
Yep.
Because that's what happened in Rise of Skywalker, and that's where we'll end it. So thank you so much for checking it out. So make sure to comment, subscribe.
The wrong way. Six.
Howdy, man.
And you know, have a good time. Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Mm-hmm. 20,000 likes.